हेलो माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, माई सेल्फ डॉक्टर पीताम्बर हुमने, फाउंडर बॉटनी फॉर यू एंड वर्किंग एज एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर एंड हेड डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ बॉटनी, धर्मपेट एम पी देव मेमोरियल साइंस कॉलेज नागपुर महाराष्ट्र इंडिया, वेलकम्स यू ऑल इन दिस लेक्चर सीरीज ऑन एंजियोस्पर्म टैक्सोनॉमी। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी द 15th लेक्चर इन दिस लेक्चर सीरीज ऑन बेंथम एंड हुकर्स सिस्टम ऑफ क्लासिफिकेशन। Whenever we are going to study the angiosperm taxonomy or the angiosperm systematics, it is very important to understand the origin and evolution of the organism. And if we want to understand the origin and evolution of these organisms from angiosperms, it is very important to understand the classification which are given by the different authors. And the most important and widely used system of classification is known as Bentham and Hooker's system of the classification. It is included in almost every syllabi of angiosperm taxonomy in different universities all over the India, and hence this lecture will be very much important for the students of UG as well as the PG, and even those research scholars who are working in the field of angiosperm taxonomy, they will also be able to understand the Bentham and Hooker's system of the classification through this lecture. So the two British botanists associated with Royal Botanic Gardens, Kew, London, that is George Bentham and Joseph Dalton Hooker, jointly published a system of classification in three volumes of Genera Plantarum, which was published originally in Latin from July 1862 to April 1883, and which is widely used all over the world. If you see this classification, then you will find that this classification, which is given by Bentham and Hooker, is a natural system of the classification, as Bentham and Hooker uses many characters for the classification of the different angiosperms. Sir George Bentham is a self-learned taxonomist, and he has been studied various plants from the angiosperms, and also before the publication of this Genera Plantarum with the Hooker, he has published several monographs on the different families and as well as the flora of Australia. He has donated more than 1 lakh plant specimens to the Royal Botanical Garden, Kew, and hence later on he is associated with the Royal Botanical Garden. After his donation, the director of the Botanical Garden, that is Williams Hooker, who is father of Sir Joseph Dalton Hooker, invited him and provided the cottage at the Kew, London. Joseph Dalton Hooker is a son of William Hooker, and later on he was working as an assistant director and a director of the Royal Botanical Garden, Kew. Both these scientists uses the various plants practically. They have studied the different characteristics. They have dissected each and every plant available, and later on the basis of their own study, they have created or constructed the classification which we are using as a Bentham and Hooker's system of the classification. In these three volumes, if you see their work, then you will find that here they have published it in the span of 1862 to 1883, means around the 20 years of the span. On the basis of this, we can conclude their hard work and dedication in the field of angiosperm taxonomy. If we see this classification which is given by the Bentham and Hooker, then we will find that the certain concepts or the certain facts they have considered in their classification. First of all, this classification is based on A.P. de Candolle's system, but they were disagree in many respects. In the system of the classification, more emphasis was given on the nature of perianth, especially number of holes and the inner hole free or the fused. Whenever we are talking about the perianth, here it is considered that the accessory hole, which is the calyx and corolla, and the corolla is the inner hole. So the corolla, that is the petals which are either free or fused, this character is prominently taken in this classification. The genera Plantarum includes 97,205 plant species, which belongs to 7,569 genera, 202 natural orders. Earlier, there were only 200 natural orders that we are considering nowadays as the families. But later on, the two families, that is the Walkeriaceae and Carylee, at the 20A and the 46A position in the classification respectively. And hence here, now this 200 plus two families becomes the 202 natural orders or the families, which are included in the 25 cohorts, which nowadays we are considering as a orders, and 21 series and 3 subclasses from the dicotyledons, and 3 classes, that is dicotyledon, gymnosperms and monocotyledons. The family Ranunculaceae from Ranales are considered as the most primitive, and Gramini, nowadays Poaceae, to be the most advanced families in the angiosperms. And in today's condition also, we are considering as a Ranunculaceae or the Ranales as one of the primitive family among the angiosperms. This system is followed in many herbaria in Europe and Asia, like the Royal Botanical Garden, Kew, London, and even Central National Herbarium, Howrah, West Bengal, in India also. In many countries in the British Empire as well as the US, in most of the herbaria are following the Bentham and Hooker's system of the classification. If you see the total number of the different plant species or the genera in the Bentham and Hooker system of the classification, which indicate here the natural orders, it indicate nowadays as the families. Here we have given the 200 families, and later on the two families are added in the polypetaly, and in this way the 200 earlier families of the Bentham and Hooker system of the classification becomes 202. Here there are the 265 families from the dicotyledons and 34 families from the monocotyledons, and this 202 families includes these 3 families of the gymnosperms also. And hence we can say that if we see the only angiosperms, then 199 families were described by Bentham and Hooker from angiosperms. So total 97,205 species were studied by Bentham and Hooker for the construction of this classification. Here, this is a easiest way to learn about the system of the classification, so that we will be able to understand how this classification is constructed. Here, the Bentham and Hooker classified the spermatophyta or the phanerogams. Spermatophyta means the seed bearing plants, or phanerograms or the also called the flower bearing organisms. So first of all, they are classified into the three classes, that is, first one dicotyledons, second one gymnosperms, and third one monocotyledons. Here the position of the gymnosperm is in between the dicot and the monocotyledons, and hence it is one of the most important demerit of this classification. Later on, the dicot is classified into three subclasses, that is, polypetaly, second one is gamopetaly, and third one, that is monoclamaly. Then again, the polypetaly is classified into three series, that is thalamiflory, diciflory, and calyciflory, on the basis of arrangement of the petals, arrangement of the sepals and ovary, and presence and absence of the disc at the base of the ovary. Then gamopetaly again classified into the three series, that is the inferi, heteromeri, and bicarpellate. Here the monoclamaly is classified into the eight different series, that is curvimbri, then multiovulati aquatici, multiovulati terrestris, then microembryoni, daphnales, achlamydospori, unisexuals, and ordins anomaly, that is the families with the doubtful positions. And the monocotyledons again are classified into the seven series, which includes the microspermy, epigyny, coronary, calycine, nudiflory, apocarpy, and glumacy. So here in this classification, this glumacy, which include the cypressee and the poaceae, are considered as a most advanced families. And if we see the initiation of this classification, that is from the thalamiflory, that is here the first natural order or the cohort which is considered as a order is the Ranelles, means which is considered as a most primitive. So the thalamiflory is classified again into the six cohorts nowadays as a orders, that is the Ranelles, Parietales, Polygalini, Caryophyllini, Gattiferi, and Malus. Likewise, the Diciflory is also classified into the four cohorts, Gentianales, then Olacales, Silastrales, and Sapindales, with two families with the doubtful positions or the similarity. Then again, the Calyciflory classified into the five cohorts or the orders, that is Rosales, Myrtales, Passiflorales, Ficoidales, and Umbellales. In the similar manner, the Inferi again classified into the three cohorts, that is Rubiales, Asterales, and Campanulales, and heteromery again into the three cohorts, Erichels, Ebenels, and Primulels, and the bicarpality classified into the four different cohorts, that is Gentianellis, Polemoniels, then Personels, and Lamiels. And in this way, all the plants which were studied by Bentham and Hooker are classified into these different cohorts, which includes the natural orders. And these natural orders, which are considered by the Bentham and Hooker in their classification, we are considering it nowadays as a families. So all these plants, which are more than 97,000, which are classified into 202 families by Bentham and Hooker. So we will see the synopsis which is given by Bentham and Hooker in their classification system. So first of all, that we have seen the dicotyledons, then gymnosperm and monocotyledons. So out of that, we will see the first class, that is dicotyledons. Whenever we are talking about the dicotyledons, so here there are the correlation of the characteristics, that is the taproot, reticulate type of the venation, presence of the two cotyledons, flowers tetra or pentamerous. So whenever we are talking about the dicotyledons or any plant which comes under the dicotyledons, then we will find that these different characteristics will be present in that organism. And so all these characteristics will be together present in the members of dicotyledons, and hence such type of the characters are considered as correlated characters. This dicotyledon later on again classified into the three different subclasses, of which the first class, that is the polypetaly. The polypetaly means the perianth of flowers, usually in two whorls, indicate the calyx, and second one is a corolla. And the inner, that is the corolla, polypetalous, means the petals are free. So the plants which belong to polypetaly bearing the corolla with the free petals. And the first series of polypetaly, that is thalamiflora. In thalamiflora, the plants includes bearing the hypogynous, that is hypogynous flowers, means ovary is superior, and sepals usually distinct and separate, means free, and even they are free from the ovary, means here in the thalamiflora, the sepals are not attached to the wall of the ovary. It is again classified into number of orders. First one, that is Ranelles. When we are talking about the Ranelles, here the flowers are spirocyclic, means the arrangement of the different floral holes are present in a spiral manner. And the gynoecium is apocarpous, that is the carpels are free. And the different families, that is the eight families, are included in the Ranelles. That is the Ranunculaceae, the genus is Ranunculus, even the Delphinium. Then Delenia, from the family Delaniaceae. Then Calycanthaceae, Magnoliaceae, the Magnolia champaca, which is the well-known chaffa, comes under the family Magnoliaceae. Unknownaceae, Unknona squamosa, custard apple, which comes under the Unknownaceae family. Then Menispermaceae, Coculus hirsutus, which is one of the most important plant from this family. Then Barberidaceae, Nymphaeaceae, which belongs to the plant Nymphaea. So these eight families comes under the Ranelles, bearing the apocarpous gynoecium. The second one, that is the Parietales, and here the carpels are united. Means this is the difference in between the Ranelles and the Parietales. In the Ranelles, the carpels are free, and in the parietalis the carpels are fused. Then united unilocular ovary, then stamens definite or even the numerous. And the most important, that is the type of the placentation, is parietal, which includes again 9 different families, that is Sarraceniaceae, Papaveraceae, the most common plant of the Papaveraceae, that is Argemon mexicana, then Cruciferae, which is now the name changed, that is the Brassicaceae, which include the Brassica, then Raphanus, Eruca, etc. Then Caparidaceae. Caparis is one of the most important plant. Racidaceae, then Cystini, Violaceae, Viola, or Ionodium is one of the plant from this family. Then Conilaceae and Bigzini. So these are the different 9 families having the united carpels with the parietal placentation. The third order or the included in the thalamic flora, and that is the Polygalini. And this Polygalini having the characteristic that is ovary is bilocular, rarely uni or multilocular, and the stamens as many as or twice the number of petals. Means if there are the presence of 5 petals, the stamens will be either 5 or twice, means the double the number of petals, that is 10, which includes the 4 families or the natural orders as per the classification which is given by the Bentham and Hooker, that is the Pittosporales, Trimandri, then Polygaly and Vacciaceae. And this family was added later on in 200 families which were earlier proposed by the Bentham and Hooker. The fourth one, cohort or the order, is Caryophyllini. And the Caryophyllini or the members of the Caryophyllini shows the carpels united to unilocular ovary, then stamens definite or numerous, which include the 4 different families, that is Frankeniaceae, then Caryophyllaceae, which includes the Vaccaria pyramidata and Polycarpia corymbosa, then the Portulacaceae, the most common, that is Ghol Portulaca, which comes under the family Portulacaceae, then Tamaraceae. The fifth one cohort or the order is the Guttiferales, which is identified by ovary try to multilocular, sepals imbricate, which is the characteristic feature of the Guttiferales, and stamens are many. This includes the 6 families, that is the Elatini, Hypericini, Guttiferi, then Transtromiaceae, Dipterocarpaceae and Clinaceae. So these are the 6 different families which are included in the Guttiferales. The 6th order or the cohort of the Thalamiflora includes the Malvales, which is the most common for its occurrence, and it shows the stamens are indefinite, means the many stamens. Arrangement of the sepal is velvet, that is the estivation. Then ovary is try to multilocular, and usually the placentation is axile. The Malvales include three different families, that is Malvaceae, Hibiscus rosa-sinensis, which is one of the most well-known plant to everyone, which include the family Malvaceae, Abutilon, Cyda, Malvaviscum, Abelmoscus. These are the very common plants of this family. Then the second family, that is Sterculiaceae, Sterculia urens, Belocia corporifolia, Helicteris isora. These are the well-known common plants of the family Sterculiaceae. Then Tiliaceae, the third member, that is the Grevia, is the most common genus. Then Corchorus, Triumphata, these are the well-known common plants of this family. The second series, that is Thalamiflorae, and the Thalamiflorae bear again the hypogynous type of the flower, which is again similar type of the characteristics to that of the Thalamiflorae, but it is different in presence of disc. Here disc is usually present in the form of ring or the cushion around or below the ovary, and sepals are free or united to the ovary. And on this basis, here, because of the presence of the disc at the base of the ovary or around the ovary, here the name is, that is Disciflorae. The Disciflorae includes the order or the cohort, that is geraniels, and the characteristic feature of the members which includes in the geraniels are the flowers often irregular, that is zygomorphic, disc usually annular, means circular in outline, then adnate to the stamens, androecia of diplostemonis, and ovules pendulous. So in this way, here there are the characteristics for the geraniels. This includes the 11 families. The first one is Linii, then Humeriaceae, then Malpighiaceae, and the most common genus of the Malpighiaceae is Aspidopteris cordata, then Zygophyllaceae, that is Terrestris or Tribulus terrestris, is the most common member of this family, then Geraniaceae, Rutaceae, that is Muraya, Eagle marmelos, these are the most common, citrus, so these are the common plants from the family Rutaceae, then Cimarobaceae, Ailanthus excelsa is a most common member of this family, then Ocnaceae, Berseraceae, Boswellia cirrata, Garuga pinnata, these are the most common members of the family Berseraceae, then Meliaceae, that is Soemida febrifuga, then Melia azadirach, then Azadirachta indica, these are the common plants of this family, then Chiletiaceae. So these are the different 11 different families which are included in the seventh order of Disciflorae. The next order in the Disciflorae is Olacales, and in Olacales the flowers are regular. I mean, this is again the difference in between the earlier order and Olacales. Then Uni are bisexual flowers, disc cupular or even the annular, androecia diplostemonis. So this is the difference in between these two. And ovules are pendulous, which include the three different families, that is Olaceae, Iliaceae, and the third one is Cyrillaceae. And this family is again added later on in addition to that of the 200 families. So the earlier family, that is Wauquiezaceae and this Cyrillaceae, these two families which are added in that 200 families of the Bentham and Hooker system of the classification, and hence later on it becomes 202 families. The next order or the cohort is Cilostrales, and it can be identified on the basis of regular flowers which are bisexuals, and the disc is adnate to the base of the calyx, means the calyx are attached to the base of the disc. Then the stamens equal to the number of petals or fever, means either the stamens will be equal to the number of petals or less than the number of petals. This includes Cilostrinae, that is nowadays family Cilostraceae, and this includes the Cilostrus paniculatus, Cassin glauca, and Metanus emarginatus. So these are the most common plants of the family Cilostraceae. Then Stockhausii, then Ramnii, that is the Ramnaceae, and in a Ramnaceae the most common plant, that is Ventilago denticulata, Gigibus jujuba, etc. And the fourth one member or the fourth one family in the Cilostrales, that is Ampelidae. The next order, that is 10th cohort or the 10th order, is Sapindales, and Sapindales is different than earlier one with the irregular flowers, that is zygomorphic flowers, even unisexuals, and presence of the disc which are adnate to the base of the calyx or lining it, and the stamens are definite, means usually the number of stamens are equal to the number of petals. This includes the five different natural orders or the families, that is Sapindaceae, which includes the Dodonia viscosa, Sapindus, and even the most common vine, that is Cardiospermum helicacabum. Then Sabiaceae, Anacardiaceae, that is the Anacardium occidentalis, Mangifera indica, which are the common plants of this family. Then Coriarini and Moringi, of which the Coriari is considered as a Ordens anomaly, that is with the doubtful position of this family. The next order, that is Rosales, which includes in the third series, that is Calyciflorae. The first one we have seen the Thalamiflorae, second one as a Diciflorae, and the third one now, that is a Calyciflorae. And in a Calyciflorae, the flowers are perigynous or epigynous. In the first one we have seen the hypogynous flower, in the second one, that is Diciflorae, we have seen the hypogynous flower, but there were the presence of the disc, and here the ovary is either perigynous, means half inferior or half superior, or epigynous, the ovary is inferior, and the sepals are united and very rarely free, often adnate to the ovary. So these are the characteristic feature of the third series in the Polypetalae, that is Calyciflorae. So the order, that is Rosales, include the organism with the bisexual, regular or irregular flowers, then carpels one to many, styles distinct, and stamens indefinite, means here in the members of Calyciflorae there are the numerous stamens, carpels are few to many, but the ovary is either perigynous or epigynous flowers. This includes 9 different natural orders or families, that is Conariaceae, second one is a Leguminosae, and the Leguminosae nowadays considered as a family Fabaceae, which includes 3 different subfamilies, Papilionidae, then Caesalpinioidae and Mimosoidae. And if we see now the recent classification, these are treated as a independent families, that is the Papilionaceae, Caesalpinioidae and Mimosaceae. And this family is based upon its type of the fruit, that is legume, that is the fruit which is developing from monocarpellary superior ovary and is dehiscent type of the fruit. There are many members of the legume. All the plants which bears the legume, they comes under the Leguminosae. Then third one is a Rosaceae, that is the rose plant, Rosa indica. Then Saxifragaceae, Crassulaceae, which includes the Calanchopinnata. Then Droseraceae, that is the Drosera, Hamamelidaceae, Bruniaceae and Halorgaceae. So these are the 9 different families or the natural orders which comes under the Rosales. The next one, that is the 12th order or the cohort, that is the Myrtales, which includes the regular bisexual flowers with the inferior ovary, styles undivided and stamens definite, rarely indefinite. This include 6 different families, that is Rhizophoraceae, that is Rhizophora is one of the most common member of this family. Then Combretaceae, Combretum is one of the member. Then Myrtaceae, the most common member of the Myrtaceae is Callistemon citrinus, Eucalyptus, etc. Then Melastomaceae, then Lythraceae, that is Amania, Rotala, these are the most common, Lagerstomia, so these are the most common plants of the Lythraceae. Then Onagraceae, Ludwigia or the Jassia, these are the common plants of the family Onagraceae. So these 6 families are included in the order, that is Myrtales. The 13th order or the cohort, that is the Passiflorales from the Calyciflora, which includes the flowers are uni or the bisexual, ovary is inferior, unilocular with the parietal placentation. This include 7 different natural orders or the families, that is Samidaceae, Loisaceae, Turneraceae, Passifloraceae, that is the passion flower, which include in the family Passifloraceae. Passiflora foetida is one of the wild plant from this family. Then Cucurbitaceae, Cucurbita, then Momardica carantia. So these are the different plants from the family Cucurbitaceae. Then Begoniaceae and Datiscaceae. So these are the 7 different families which are included in the Passiflorales. The 14th order in Bentham and Hooker system of the classification is Ficoidales, and the characteristic feature of the Ficoidales is perianth undifferentiated. This indicates that here when we are talking about its differentiation into the calyx and corolla, so in such a situation we can say that the perianth is differentiated into the 2 different whorls. But when it is undifferentiated, we will not be able to find out any difference in between the calyx and corolla. And in such a situation, it is considered that the perianth is undifferentiated. Exile or the basal placentation, and the embryo is curved, which is the characteristic feature of the ficoidals. This include the cacti, that is today's cactaceae, which includes the genus that is Apuntia, and the second one family or the natural order, that is Ficoidae. The next one, that is the 15th cohort or the order, is umbelles, and in umbelles the flowers are regular, rarely irregular, ovary is inferior, and inflorescence is umbellate. So the umbellate inflorescence is a characteristic feature of this cohort or the order, and this include three different natural orders or families, that is Umbelliferi, then Araliaceae and Cornaceae. So here the most common, that is Dhania, which is from the Umbelliferi, then Trachispermum omni, that is also the member of the family Umbelliferi. Then second one subclass, that is Gamopetali. Now up to this one we have seen the members of Polypetali in the form of Thalamiflori, then Diciflori and Calyciflori. Now the Gamopetali means here the perianth of flower usually in again two holes, and inner hole, that is the corolla, is with the united petals, means gamopetals, and hence it is the name given Gamopetali, which includes the series, that is inferi, and the inferi means the stamens as many as corolla lobes. That is, if there are the 5 petals, then there will be the 5 stamens. Then alternate with them means the stamens are alternating with the petals, and the ovary is inferior, which is the characteristic feature of this series inferi. This includes the order, that is Rubiales, in which the plants included having the flowers regular or irregular, stamens epipetalous, means attached to the petals, and ovary bilocular with one to many ovules in each locule. And the Rubiales includes two families, that is Caprifoliaceae and Rubiaceae. The Ixora is the most common plant from the family Rubiaceae. Then the next order or the cohort is Asterales. In Asterales, the flowers are regular or irregular. Stamens are epipetalous, ovary is unilocular and one ovule. This include the four different families or the natural orders, that is Valeriani, then Dipsaceae, Calyceri and Compositae. And the most common is Compositae among all these families, which include the sunflower, Azeratum conizoid, Vernonia cinerea, Triadax procumbens, etc. So these are the most common plant from this family. The next one, that is Campanules, which include the plants with the irregular flowers, that is zygomorphic flowers, ovary 2 to 6 locular with the many ovules in each locule. And this include the three different families, that is Stylidae, Gudonivi, and Campanulaceae. And the most common member of the Campanulaceae is Wallenbergia marginata. The next series from the Gamopetali, and that is Heteromeri, which include the plant having the carpels more than 2 and stamens as many as corolla lobes or even the more. Means either there will be the equal number of stamens to that of the petals or more than the number of petals. This includes the orders like the Ericales, and the Ericales include the flowers with the stamens as many as corolla lobes and alternating with the petals. This includes 6 different families, that is Ericaceae, then Vacciniaceae, Monotropi, Epacridae, Diependiaceae, and Linoaceae. So these are the uncommon families for the plants which are found in our area. The next one, that is Primulales, which includes the plants with the stamens as many as corolla lobes, then opposite to the petals. See the difference in between the Ericales and Primulales. In Ericales, the stamens are alternating to the petals, and in Primulales, the stamens are opposite to the petals. Then ovary is unilocular and placentation is free central or the basal. Ovules 1 to many. This include 3 different families, that is Plumbaginae, then Primulaceae and Myrsiaceae. So Plumbago gelanica, Plumbaginaceae nowadays, then Anagallis arabensis, which is the most common plant from the family Primulaceae, and Myrsini, that is nowadays Myrsinaceae. Imbelia basal is one of the plant from the family Myrsini. The next order, that is Ebenales, which includes the plants with the stamens usually more than corolla lobes. Means here the number of stamens are more than the total number of petals in each flower. Or if as many as the petals, then opposite to them, and the ovary 2 to many locular, and the ovules are few. The Ebenales include 3 different families or the natural orders, that is Supportaceae, which includes the Madhuka indica, Manilkara zapota, and Mimosops ilengi. So these are the common plants of the Supportaceae. Then Ebenaceae, that is Diospyros, is one of the most common plant, and Styraceae, the 3rd family in the Ebenales. The next series in Gamopetali, and that is Bicarpelaceae. Bi means 2 and carpels. So here the carpels are 2, rarely few or more, ovary superior, stamens as many as or less than corolla lobes. Means here the most important is that presence of the 2 carpels, then ovary is superior, and the stamens are as many as, means the equal to the number of petals or less than the number of petals. This includes the order Gentianales, and this includes the plants bearing the flowers with the actinomorphic condition, then leaves opposite, then stamens epipetalous, that is attached to the petals. The gentianelles include six families, that is Oleaceae, that is Nyctanthes arbutristis and Jasminum samba, which are the common plant for the Oleaceae. Salvadora from the family Salvadoraceae, which is one of the plant. Then Apocynaceae, that is Nerium indicum. Then Thibesia. Then Tabernimontana. Then Vinca rosea. So these are the most common plant of the Apocynaceae. Then Asclepiadaceae, the most common plant of the Asclepiadaceae, and that is Calotropis procera, Asclepias curassavica, Tilosma, Bidaria cuspidata. So they are the plants from the family Asclepiadaceae. Then Loganiaceae, that is Mitriola, and Gentianaceae, that is Hoppea, Canscora, Exacum, etc. The next order or the cohort in the bicarpellate is Polymoniales, which includes the plants with regular flowers or the corolla, then stamens as many as corolla lobes, again epipetalous, that is they are attached to the petals, then ovary 1 to 5 locular and leaves alternate. So this is again the difference in between the gentianelles and the Polymoniales, that in the gentianelles here the leaves are opposite and in a Polymoniales the leaves are alternate. This includes the five different natural orders or the families, that is Polymoniaceae, Hydrophyllaceae, then Boraginaceae, Convolvulaceae and Solanaceae. Heliotropium is the most common plant, Coldenia, then Trichodesma. So these are the very common plant from the family Boraginaceae. Ipomea, then Meremia. So these are the Argyria. So these are the very common plants from the family Convolvulaceae. Then Solanaceae, Solanum xanthocarpum, Solanum melongena, Solanum tuberosum, Capsicum. So these are the most common plants from the family Solanaceae. The next order from the bicarpellate, and that is Persoonales, which includes the plant bearing the flowers zygomorphic, then corolla often bilipped. This is again now one of the additional character. Then stamens fewer than corolla lobes, ovary 1 to 2 or rarely 4 locular, and ovules usually numerous. And the Persoonales includes 8 different natural orders or families, that is Scrofulariaceae, and this includes the common plant, that is Lindernia, Lindenbergia, then Scoparia dulcis. So these are the, there are the many plants from this family. Then Orobanchaceae, Orobanchi is one of the root parasite from this family. Then Lentibulariaceae, all the species of the Utricularia, which is the insectivorous plants that comes under the Lentibulariaceae. Then Columeliaceae, Gesneriaceae, then Bignoniaceae, which includes the Dolichondron falcata, Stereospermum, Kygelia pinnata, Tichoma stans, etc. Then Pedaliaceae, then Acanthaceae. So these are again the most common, Asteracantha, which is the most common plant of the Acanthaceae family. So such type of the 8 different families are included in the cohort personals. The next cohort or the order, that is lamials, which includes the again zygomorphic flowers, then corolla, often bilipped, stamens as many as or fewer than the corolla lobes, then ovary, 2 to 4 locules, locular, and the ovules are 4. This include 5 different natural orders or families, that is Myoporini, Psyllageni, then Verbenaceae. The most common plant of the Verbenaceae is Lantana camara, Tectona grandis, etc. Then Labiatae, which includes the most common, that is the Osimum sanctum or Osimum tenuiflorum. Then Plantagenaceae. So these are the 5 different natural orders or the families which are included in the cohort lamials in the Bentham-Haar-Sukars system of the classification. Then the next one, that is Monochlamydiae, that is the 3rd subclass. And the Monochlamydiae means the flowers with one whorl of the perianth, commonly sepalloid or absent. Means here the perianth is not distinguished into the 2 different whorls like the calyx and corolla. There is only presence of the single whorl. It is sepalloid, means it is green in color, or sometimes even the perianth lobes are found to be absent. So such type of the plants are included in the Monochlamydiae. The Monochlamydiae include the series, that is Curvembrae. This include the terrestrial plants with the bisexual flowers, and the stamens usually equal in number to the perianth. Ovules solitary, and the embryo is curved. So this is a characteristic feature of the Curvembrae, means the embryo is curved. And this includes 7 natural orders or families, that is Nyctogeni, which includes the Boerewia diffusa, Mirabilis jalapa or Bougainvillea, then Illicibraceae, Amaranthaceae, the most common Amaranthus, which comes under the Amaranthaceae, Acheranthus aspera, which is again one of the most common plant from the family Amaranthaceae, then Chenopodiaceae, that is Chenopodium album, which is the most common plant from the family Chenopodiaceae, Daucus carota, Beta vulgaris, these are the different plants from the Chenopodiaceae family, then Phytolaxaceae, Batidae, and Polygonaceae, the Polygonum species, Persicaria. So these are the different plants which comes under the Polygonaceae. The next series, that is Multi-Ovulatae Aquaticae, that the aquatic plants with the syncarpous ovary and the many ovules, and this include the single family, that is the Podostemaceae. The next series, that is Multi-Ovulatae Terrestris, which includes the terrestrial plants with the syncarpous ovary and many ovules. Here only the difference in between the Multi-Ovulatae Aquaticae and Multi-Ovulatae Terrestris, that the habitat is different. One is aquatic and another one is terrestrial. This includes 3 different natural orders or the families, that is Nepenthaceae, that is Nepenthes, which is again one of the insectivorous plants, which comes under the in family Nepenthaceae, then Cytinaceae, and the third one, that is the Eristolochaceae. The most common member of this family, that is the Eristolochia. The next series, that is microembryoi. Micro means very small, and embryoi means the embryo, and hence it is considered that the plants bearing the minute embryo, ovary is apocarpus or syncarpus, means with the free carpels or even the fused carpels, and ovules usually solitary. Here this includes the Piperaceae, Piper Betel, Chloranthaceae, Myristicaceae, and Monimiaceae. So these are the four different families which are included in the series, that is microembryoni. The next series, that is Daphnales, which include the ovary, usually one carpeled, that is presence of the single carpel, monocarpellary ovary, then ovules solitary or few, and perianth sepaloid, that is green, in one or two whorl. Either the perianth is present in the single whorl or the two whorls. This includes the five different natural orders or the families, that is Laurinii, Proteaceae, Thymelaceae, Pennaceae, and Ilindinaceae. So these are the five different families which are included in the Daphnales. The next series, that is Acclimatosporae, and this include the plants bearing the unilocular ovary, 1 to 3 ovuled, then seeds endospermic and without testa. So this includes the family Loranthaceae, then Santalaceae, and Balanophoraceae. So the most common member of the Loranthaceae is Dendropthi falcata, which is the most common semi-parasite of the trees. Then next one, that is Santalum album, which is the most common plant of this family. Then the next series, that is unisexuals. Uni means one, sexuals means the sex organs, means the flowers are unisexual, means either there are the presence of the male and the female flower different. Ovary is syncarpus or one carpeled, means monocarpellary ovary. Ovules one or two per carpel. Perianth again sepaloid, means green, and much reduced or even the absent. Here it includes the nine different natural orders or families, that is Euphorbiaceae. The most common plants of the Euphorbiaceae is Euphorbia, Acalypha, Phyllanthus, etc. Then Balanopsis, then Urticaceae. The common plant from the Urticaceae are Posolzea and Laportia interrupta, then Plantanaceae, Litneriaceae, Juglandaceae, Myricaceae, Casuarinaceae, that is Casuarina equisetifolia, which is the most common xerophytic plant, and Cupiliferae. So these are nine different families which are included in the unisexuals, which bears the unisexual flowers, that is male flowers and the female flowers. The next series from the Monochlamydiae, that is Ordine's anomaly, means having the doubtful affinities or the positions. Flowers again are the unisexual and the families of the doubtful affinities with respect to the other members of the angiosperms. And this includes salicaceae, then lacystemaceae, empetraceae, and ceratophyllaceae. The ceratophyllum is the most common member of this family. So up to this, there are the different 165 families which are included in the dicotyledons, that is polypetali, gamopetali, and monochlamydi. The second class, that is gymnosperm, which is placed in between the dicot and the monocotyledon by Bentham and Hooker, and this includes the plant with the ovules or the seed are naked. That is, the carpels are found to be absent, and hence here there is a naked seed, means no formation of the fruit. Means here the ovary is found to be completely absent in the gymnosperm, and hence no question arises to form the fruit by the members of gymnosperms. So this include three different families, that is Nettaceae, Coniferaceae, and Cycadaceae. So these three families belong to the gymnosperm. And the third class in the Bentham and Hooker system of the classification, and that is monocotyledons. Again, if we see the monocotyledons here, there are correlated characters among these organisms, which includes adventitious type of the roots, means the roots which are developing other than the part of the radical, then presence of parallel venation and presence of one cotyledon in the seed, and flowers are trimerous, except few exceptions like the Smilax and Paris, which are the monocotyledons, but they are with the reticulate type of the venation. So except such a few exceptional cases, every time in the plants which are from the monocotyledon will show such type of the correlated characteristics, like the adventitious root system, presence of the parallel venation, one cotyledon, and trimerous type of the flowers, that is three members or multiple of three in each whorl of the flower, that is calyx, corolla, etc. This includes the series, that is microspermy, and the microspermy means the inner perianth petaloid ovary inferior. Seeds are minute. This indicate the meaning of microspermy. Micro means the minute, sperm means the seed, and the seeds are ex-albuminous, means the seeds are non-endospermic. This includes three different natural orders or the families, that is Hydrocaryticaceae, Hydrilla, then Bermaniaceae, and the most beautiful plants of the world, that is orchids, and the very common plant from our area, that is the Vanda, Habenaria. So these are the plants which belongs to the family Orchidaceae. The next series, that is Epigyne. Epigyne means the ovary is inferior, that is flowers are epigynous. Here the perianth partly petaloid, ovary is inferior, hence the flowers are epigynous, and endosperm is abundant, indicates the seeds are endospermic. This includes the seven different families, that is Scitamini, bromeliaceae, that is ananas, pomosus, which is the common plant from the bromeliaceae. Then hemodoraceae, iridi, then amaryllidaceae, which includes the crinum. There are many species of the crinum, even wild as well as the cultivated. And again, the another cultivated plant, that is Fercrea, this includes in the family Amaryllidaceae. Then Taca from the Tacaceae family, and Dioscoriaceae, the most common plants of, there are the many species of the Dioscoria from this family. The next series, that is Coronary, and this include the plants bearing the inner perianth as the petaloid. Then ovary is superior and the endosperm is absent, that is the seeds are non-endospermic. This includes 8 different natural orders or the families. Roxburghaceae, in the name of Roxburgher. Then Liliaceae, which includes the Allium sepa, Gloriosa superba, Asparagus, Aloe vera, then Sansevieria zelenica, etc. So these are the very common plant of the family Liliaceae. Then Pontederiaceae, Philidraceae, Zyridaceae, Myacaceae, Comelinaceae, which includes the plant like the Comelina, Murdania, Cynotis, and Toningia, etc. Then Rapataceae. So in this way, 8 different families are included in the Coronary. The next series in the Monocotyledon is Calycineae, which include the plant bearing the inner perianth sepaloid, rigid or herbaceous, and the ovary is superior. This includes 3 different natural orders or the families, that is Flagellariaceae, Juncaceae, and Palmi, that is the Ericaceae, which includes the most common plant, and that is coconut. The next series, that is Nudiflorae, which includes the plants bearing perianth absent or even the reduced, carpels 1 or several, ovary superior, ovules 1 to many, and endosperm present, means the seeds are endospermic. And this include the 5 different families, that is Pandani, that is the Pandanaceae in today's, that is Pandanus is one of the genus, Cyclanthaceae, Typhaceae, the Typha is the most common genus for this family, then Aroidae, that is Araceae family, most of the aroids comes under this family, that is Pistia, Alocasia, Holocasia, then Amorphophallus, etc. Then Lemmaceae, that is the Wolffia, is the most common plant of this family. The next series, that is the Apocarpi. Apocarpi means the carpels are free. Here the plants which belong to this Apocarpi include the perianth in 1 or 2 holes or even the absent, ovary superior, Apocarpus, and endosperm absent, that is the seeds are non-endospermic. This includes 3 different natural orders or the families, that is Triuridae, then Alismaceae, and Najadaceae. So the Sagittaria is the most common genus from the family Alismaceae, now known as the Alismataceae, and the Najas major, Najas minor, these are the different species from the family Najadaceae. Series in the Monocotyledon that is Glumaceae, which includes the plant bearing the flowers solitary, sessile, in the axil of bracts or arranged in heads or spikelet, with the glums and perianth scale-like or even the absent. Ovary unilocular with single ovule and endosperm present. So this include the five different natural orders or the families, that is Iriocolli, which is commonly now called the Iriocolliaceae family, the most common genus, that is the Iriocolon. Then Centrolepidaceae, Restiaceae, then Cypraceae and Gramineae. The most common plants of the Cypraceae includes Cypress, Iliocaris, Mariscus, Furena, Scirpus, Fimbriatilis, etc. And the last family in the classification of Bentham and Hooker, and that is the Gramineae, and which is also known as Poaceae according to the International Code of the Botanical Nomenclature, that with the help of suffix A-C-E-A to the family. This includes the Bamboo, Oryza sativa, Triticum vulgari, Vetiveria jejunioides. So these are the different and most common plant from this family. So total, including the two families at the 20th A and 46th A position, here the total families becomes 202. So if you see this complete system which is proposed by the Bentham and Hooker, which is a very useful from the practical point of view, because the greater number of categories means anyone can easily use this classification which is proposed by the Bentham and Hooker for the identification of the genera. Each category is well defined with the distinguishing characters. And if we see step by step for the identification, so this classification will be very much helpful for the identification of the organisms. Although the system is not phyletic, means here during this system of the classification formation, they have not considered the phylogeny. But then also, at placing the Ranelles in the beginning of the dicot, because we have seen the Ranelles is the first cohort or the order in the system of Bentham and Hooker's classification. And this justifies the order beginning most primitive among the flowering plants. And if you see the characteristic features of the angiosperm, then the Ranelles is one of the primitive angiosperm which is placed just at the initiation of the classification by Bentham and Hooker. In the similar way, if we see the umbelles in the end of the polypetaly also reflect the phylogenetic pattern, because this order is regarded as the most advanced among the polypetalous group. This indicates that though the system which is proposed by the Bentham and Hooker, it is a natural system of the classification, but on the various characteristics on the basis of their placement of the different orders and the families arrangement, it shows that it is a phylogenetic also. Then placing of the monocot after the dicotyledon is justified by majority of the taxonomists today and favor the origin of monocot from the dicot. If we see the system of the classification in the angiosperm, then we will find that the dicotyledons evolved first and later on the monocotyledon. And in this classification also, the dicots are placed initially and later on the monocot, and hence again it becomes easy to use this classification. Then the natural orders, that is families of the dispute nature, are placed under the ordens anomalies. So this is again one of the merit of this classification, that the families with the doubtful position or the disputed position are placed under the ordens anomaly. Then the larger taxa are divided into the smaller subcategories to bring more clarity. And hence, this system is very much easy to use for the identification of the organism as well as for the understanding. Then the system is very handy for the purpose of quick identification of the plants even in the field. And hence here, the system of classification which is proposed by the Bentham and Hooker is largely used all over the world. Though there are the many merits, even there are many demerits also. And this includes the most important and the big drawback of this system of the classification, that placing the gymnosperm between dicot and the monocot. We have seen the first class is the dicotyledon, second one is the gymnosperm, and third one is the monocotyledon. So this gymnosperm is placed in between the dicot and the monocotyledon, as it is a completely different group with respect to that of the presence and absence of the carpel or formation of the fruit in the angiosperm and no formation of the fruit in the gymnosperm. Hence, it is a irrelevant position of the gymnosperm in between the dicot and the monocot. And hence, it is one of the biggest demerit of the classification proposed by the Bentham and Hooker. Then several important floral characters have not been given proper respect which they deserve, because now we have seen that the characteristics like the petals are free, petals are fused, presence of the disc, absence of the disc, ovary is superior, ovary is inferior, type of the embryo, then type of the perianth. So these most common characters are considered, but other important floral characters are not considered during this classification. So that becomes again one of the demerit of this system of the classification. Then in this system, the several closely related families, that is the natural orders, have been separated and placed under different orders or the cohorts. And concurrently, the number of unrelated families have been closely placed. So this is again one of the disadvantage or the demerit of this system of the classification. Then the subclass, that is Monochlamydiae, is very heterogeneous and superfluous group, because the family is placed under different series of this class exhibit closer affinities with the different families of the Polypetalidae, and therefore various families therein can very well be distributed among the various taxa of the subclass Polypetalidae. So some of the important instances which are considered by the Bentham and Hooker in their classification, but which are irrelevant also. So we will see again in addition to this some other their classification. So the families like the Amaranthaceae and Chenopodiaceae, that is placed in the subclass Monochlamydiae and series Carbembrae, show the affinities with the family Caryophyllaceae in the order Caryophyllinae series Thalamiflorae subclass Polypetalidae. So though its similarity is there with that of the Thalamiflorae, here in the Polypetalidae it is placed in the Monochlamydiae. The next one, that is the family Podostemaceae, that is included in the Monochlamydiae in the series Multiovulati Aquaticae, are closely related to the family Saxifragaceae or the Crassulaceae, which is from the order Roselles in the series Calyciflorae of the Polypetalidae. So again, here this family is placed very much away than that of the Saxifragaceae or the Crassulaceae, though it show the affinity with it. The next one, that is the Laurinaceae, which is included in the Monochlamydiae of the series Daphnales, are closely related to the family Magnoliaceae. And the Magnoliaceae comes under the primitive order of the angiosperm, that is Ranelles, in the Thalamiflorae of the Polypetalidae. So this family, that is Laurini, should be there in the close affinity of the Ranelles. Then the family Plantanaceae of the Monoclamidae series unisexuals are regarded as allied to the Roselles of family Rosaceae of subfamily Spiroidae. So in this way, here even the Plantanaceae is irrelevant positioned. Then in monocotyledons, the authors did not follow the same principles as for the dicotyledons. Directly, there is a classification of the monocotyledons into the number of series. So instead, they have placed the advanced series, that is Microspermi, that is family Orchidaceae, in the beginning, which is objectionable, because whenever we have to see the different characteristics of the family Orchidaceae, we will find that here this family is an advanced family. So it should be kept in the last and not in the beginning, because as this family showing the advanced characteristics means these are the plants which are highly developed, and so such type of the plant should be placed at the end of the classification or in the lateral stage of the classification and not in the beginning, because it is not the primitive type of the characteristics. So thank you very much for listening the complete lecture in this lecture series on angiosperm taxonomy. If this lecture series is useful for the students of UG and PG, then kindly like, share and subscribe our YouTube channel, and also press bell icon for the alerts of every lecture to be uploaded on different life sciences titles. Thanks a lot once again.